Good evening, everyone. My name is Kyle Perez, and I'm honored to be officiating this wedding today. We've gathered here today to celebrate the union of Lonnie and John, and I thank each of you for being here, especially in these uncertain times. Know that it means the world to them that each of you are present to witness the love they share. Anyone who knows the two of them, especially the efficiency-driven emergency doctor, Lonnie, knows that a protracted and drawn-out three-hour ceremony was never in the cards. I would like to start by giving you a window into their relationship, not as I see it, but as they have communicated to me. In preparation for this day, I asked each of them the same questions: how they met, what they meant to each other, what marriage meant to each of them. Their responses are unknown to the other, and drawing upon these answers, I would like to briefly share what I think is their story. Both Lonnie and John have a deep and abiding drive to care for the less fortunate. While they grew up less than 15 minutes away from each other in New Jersey, they actually first met in South Korea, both volunteering at a leper colony. As the other American there, Lonnie introduced herself to John in formal Korean, and the two quickly realized their shared mutual roots back home in the U.S. They kept in touch when they returned to America, and they became close friends quite quickly, possibly even too close. Both Lonnie and John worried about ruining their friendship for more romantic aspirations, and mentioned being in each other's friend zone for about 2 years before taking the leap. When asked about the decision to risk that friendship, John describes it as simultaneously brave and stupid. Lonnie said she had already spent 2 years falling in love with him. John, Lonnie loves you for many reasons, but here are some highlights. Your patience has shown her the value of responding as opposed to reacting, and that sometimes less is more. She trusts you and finds you to be a kind person. She respects and admires your intelligence. She values your ability as a listener, especially at 4 a.m. after a bad day in the hospital. And for letting her make the decisions that you know she needs to get to on her own. She likes your friends and knows that you are loyal to a fault. She may have mentioned that each of them gave her a stern talking to when you started dating to ensure that you wouldn't get hurt. Lonnie, John loves you for many reasons, but here are some of the highlights. He admires your confidence and independence. He is slightly awestruck by the amount you care for your patients, for your family, for your friends, for your dog Song, and for him. He loves your belief in a strong family and hopes to use that as the foundation for your future together. He knows that you too are loyal to a fault. His only concern is that you might love Song more than him. Both of you focus on how much you value exploring the world together, trying new things, and making memories to last a lifetime. Both of you adore food and spend an inordinate amount of time trying to convey the magic of a single bite of fish at a fancy omakase in Japan. A time when you both experienced utter happiness and immediately looked for the other. And while we're on the topic of fish and travel, Bonnie, John wants you to know that he adores your love for aquariums and will continue scheduling visits to every aquarium he can in all your future vacations. But you also both find love in the mundane, in the everyday, and taking care of each other. You both view marriage as a partnership that is deeply seated in the trust you already have for one another. A commitment through the tough times, the exciting times, the challenges, and the successes. A blend of several different types of love. Yes, romantic, but also kinship, friendship, and unconditional togetherness. On behalf of all those gathered here today, I would like to offer our support as you take this next step together. May you continue to find those omakase moments of pure happiness, and may you always immediately look for the other. At this point, I would like to invite John and Lonnie to share the vows they have each personally written.
Lonnie, I feel incredibly lucky to be standing up here with you today. You are the love of my life and my best friend. I love that we started out as friends. We got to know a lot about each other, and you saw me for who I truly am. I promise to be there through the good times and the bad. I promise to always be there when you have troubles and to know that sometimes simply listening to you talk about your problems is enough. I love that you care so much about your family and friends, and I'm very thankful to be surrounded by so many of these loving people. With the support and guidance from them, our love will not live in isolation, but will be a source of strength to help nourish those around us. We traveled halfway around the world to first meet, and I can't wait to continue to travel with you. I vow to always be your travel buddy and to prioritize aquariums wherever we go. I love that you laugh at my terrible jokes, and I vow that laughter will always be found in our home. You have gone through different hair colors during the time I've known you, pink, silver, blonde, to name a few. But even when we grow old and our hair becomes gray, I promise to love you and cherish you, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. I love you.
John, I'm not someone who believes in fate or soulmates, but standing here in front of you today and thinking about how we met 10,000 miles away on a leper colony in South Korea, although we lived 5 minutes away from each other from our home, I can't help but wonder if we weren't meant to be. We were close friends before you became my boyfriend, and just like everything that you do, you're really good at it. But what I love the most about our relationship so far has been that you never stopped being my best friend. You've been like this big warm blanket that wraps around me when I need to be held, but at the same time, also like an anchor that holds me down and steadies me when everything is chaotic around me. Yet, somehow pick me up and lift me up even higher, even on the best of my days. No matter what the circumstance, you always manage to get me to laugh. And yes, after all these years, I'll finally admit that I do find your jokes funny. John, I'm so blessed to have you by my side the past 9 years and to be standing in front of you today. I've seen how kind, gentle, patient, loyal, smart, and fun you are. Today, I promise to love you, even on those days when I might not like you very much. I promise to always to try to like you, even when you're not so likable. To defend and protect you, to respect and honor you, and arguably the most importantly, I will always continue to make fun of you. I love you, John.
Since antiquity, brides and grooms-to-be have exchanged rings as a mark of being forever bound to one another, a mark of fidelity, a physical contract, of friendship, and of love. Charles, could you please have the rings?
Lonnie, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
John, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
We will now bear witness to a unity ceremony. Dave, Matt, you would be so kind as to bring materials over, that would be wonderful. In Korean tradition, you are considered a child of your parents until you get married. Many Korean traditions are generational, and your lineage starts on the day of your marriage. This ceremony symbolizes their mother's blessing, but also, as they gave life, they are giving a part of their lives to create a new and joint family between their children. As John and Lonnie accept their mother's life to create their own, they are accepting their family's values, heritage, and blessings. At this point, we have the mothers, the bride, and the mothers. Lonnie, John. Throughout this ceremony, Lonnie and John have expressed their love for each other. With words spoken, rings given, and family's blessing, the existence of a bond between them has been formalized, save for one last thing. Do you, John An, take Lonnie So to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Do you, Lonnie So, take John An to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
By the power vested in me by church and state, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
Such a beautiful night to make a change in our lives. East tangling sky, empty bottle of wine. I got you by my side, talking about love and life. Oh, how lucky am I when I look in your eyes. What a wonderful way to spend a moment or two. To be lying awake and be here talking to you. I got something to say, I know what I gotta do. To be making a change, now the moment of truth. Why am I feeling so nervous when things are going so perfect? But I know that it's worth it to spend forever with you. And so I count to three and get on one knee and I ask you, darling, honestly, I've waited all this time just to make the hand, fingers running through hair, lips pressed to her lips, so I was caught unaware. Arms holding me tight, tears in both of her eyes. What a beautiful way to spend the rest of our lives. The sun will reappear, burning all in red. My chest was the pillow, green grass long was the bed. Last night was the night, one last moment of truth. And what a wonderful way of falling deeper in you. Why was I feeling nervous when things were going so perfect? But now I know that it's worth it to spend forever with you. And so I can't.